Hi and welcome! In this video we're gonna take a look at this PCI sound card based on the Yamaha YMF724 sound chip. This chip includes a genuine OPL3 FM synthesizer which sounds great in DOS games. The card has a 2-channel audio output and the standard ports that you would expect from a card of this era. What's even more interesting is this 5-pin header next to the sound chip marked as PCPCI. This PCPCI connector is also known as SB-Link, and its job is to improve the compatibility of these PCI cards with DOS audio. But why is this needed? Well, let me first explain very briefly how audio works in DOS. DOS was developed in an era where most cards were using the ISA bus. So a system would look like this. You had your CPU, the memory, and your expansion cards all connected to the ISA bus. When an application wanted to play digital audio, it would ask the DMA chip to send some audio data to the card. The DMA would initiate the data transfer, the sound card would start playing the audio, and the CPU would be free to do other tasks. When the sound card was done playing the audio, it would send an interrupt request to the application asking for more data. Well, all of this is specific to the ISA bus. The PCI bus works differently, and its interrupts and DMA are not compatible with the ISA ones. So all software designed to work with an ISA sound card won't work with PCI sound cards. So PCI sound cards need to implement some compatibility techniques for DOS audio to work. The Yamaha card can be configured to operate in any of the compatibility modes shown in the table. The most compatible mode is the combination of the PCPCI DMA mode and the S-IRQ mode, but this will only work on supported motherboards. The motherboard I'm using is based on the 440BX chipset and has the PCPCI link connector right next to the south bridge. The PCPCI link connector allows the sound chip to talk directly to the motherboard chipset using 3 wires. Let's take a closer look at the PCPCI connector. It has 5 pins in total, 2 of which are connected to ground. From the 3 remaining pins, 2 of them are for the DMA and 1 for the serialized IRQ. If we take a look at the pinouts of the sound chip and the motherboard chip, we can find these exact pins that are used for PCPCI. Okay, so let's plug in the sound card and install the drivers. The official Yamaha website still hosts drivers for these cards, but these only work on Windows. For DOS, I use the drivers I found on the Vogons drivers website. This contains a directory named real-dos that contains the DOS installer. Installing the driver is straightforward. You just hit enter a couple of times until the process completes. Once the installer is done, we can run the setup DS utility to configure the card. Let's try out the sound test option at the bottom. As you can see, this gives us an error that the DMA cannot be detected. This error makes sense because we have not connected the sound card to the motherboard with a PCPCI connector, which carries the DMA signals. So let's connect them. I don't actually have a PCPCI cable, so I'm gonna use a standard breadboard jumper wire with female DuPont connectors on both sides. The PCPCI headers are numbered on both sides, so we just need to connect the wires one by one. Okay, the cable is now connected. So let's try the setup DS utility once more and run the sound test. As you can see, the test passes. So let's try Quest for Glory, Shadows of Darkness. I have one more sound card with the exact same chip, the AW724 from AOpen, but this one is missing the PCPCI header. But the good news is that the solder pads are already there, so we can try adding the header ourselves. The first thing to do is to remove the existing solder from the pads. Let's start by adding some fresh solder. We can now remove the solder with the desoldering gun. Alright, so the pads are now clean and you can see through the holes. Since I don't have a 2x3 header, I'm just gonna cut a 2x3 section out of a long pit header. The PC-PCI connector is keyed, so we need to remove one of the middle pins. Before placing the header, let's clean the surface with IPA. We need to make sure that the header is placed correctly with the missing pin in pin position 3. Okay. The connector is flat against the PCB, and this is exactly what we want. Let's remove any remaining flux with IPA. We're now ready to connect the card to the motherboard. Let's run the setup DS utility once more to check if the card worked correctly. Okay, so the card seems to be working fine, but if we take a closer look, we can see that there are a lot of unpopulated components close to the header. Let's see if any of them are actually needed. Let's take a look at the other card. I'm using a multimeter in continuity mode to check how the header pins are connected to the nearby components. Okay, so this is what I found. Pin 2 and pin 3 are directly connected to ground. Then there is a 10k pull-up resistor between pin 1 and the 5V rail, and there is another 10k resistor between pin 6 and the 5V rail. And how did I know that these are 10k resistors? Well, these are SMD components that are marked with 103, so the resistor value is 10 times 10 to the power of 3, which is 10,000 ohms or 10k. Okay, so let's get back to the other card to check whether these 10k resistors are actually missing. I'm once again using the multimeter in continuity mode to find which of the pads are connected to pins 1 and 6. And yes, there are two unpopulated solder pads for the SMD resistors, with one end connected to pins 1 and 6 and the other connected to the 5V rail. Soldering SMD components is a bit tricky. I'm adding some solder to one pad, then I'm soldering the resistor to it while holding it with some tweezers. Soldering the other end is straightforward. After cleaning the board with IPA to remove any remaining flux, we can see that the solder joints don't look too bad. Okay, let's start the setup DS utility once again. Remember the table about the compatibility modes? Well, I think it's time to switch the IRQ mode from int A to serialized IRQ. And the sound test crashed the system, most probably because IRQ7 is already in use. Let's try to move the card to another PCI slot and try again. This time the setup DS utility just freezes. I tried setting IRQ5 instead, but I was getting an error. I rebooted the machine and checked the device listing, and yes, IRQ5 was in use by the serial bus controller. So I tried a couple of different slots until IRQ5 was free. Okay, let's try some games using this configuration. That's all for now. Thank you for watching and see you in a future video. Bye!